thank you cheer. How about another round of applause for the Pine Richland High School Jazz Band? And for the Pine Richland High School cheerleading team. Okay, students, this is sports, our winter dance and academic awards ceremony. We are joined in the high school gymnasium by the junior and senior classes. We are joined by many of our winter sports athletes. Our 9th and 10th grade rooms are watching from homeroom right now. We hope that you're enjoying this live stream from your homeroom. We greatly look forward to next year when the gym is renovated and we can fit our entire school in here for assemblies like that. So we're really excited about that. We are also joined, students, via live stream by parents and members of our community. If you're watching right now, thank you for joining this special recognition for us. This is a winter court assembly. We have our winter court students. We will crown a king today, and we have many parents here today as well. Thank you, parents, for joining us. Students, we're gonna get started here in a moment. We have so many fun things planned for this afternoon. It is important to recognize and take time to celebrate all of the wonderful things that go on in our high school. Each of our sports teams, our academic award winners. We also have several really cool surprises today. You're gonna get a sneak peek to something awesome happening in the spring, and let's just say it's gonna involve all 1,500 plus of us, and you might have a little bit of singing with that. It's gonna be a lot of fun. With that said, at this time, we're gonna turn it over to our Masters of Ceremony, Mr. Slim, Mr. Duggart, and Mr. Seibert, come on out. Some booze out there, guys. I don't know about that.
Boo. First up, for the winter sports team's commentary, that would be me, is the swim and dive team. Come on out, swim and dive team. The captains of the swim team is Elizabeth Schaefer, along with Justin Bogatz, and team captain for the diving team is Emily Smallwood. Swimming and diving, yeah, Emily Smallwood! Hey, we're Marco's sister. Swimming and diving return to practices and competing in the 2023 year, the goal of going back to the PIAA this meet in March. They have broken one pool record and one team record so far this year. There are several more records that the team has their sights on. They have three relays and seven individual qualities for postseason competition here in the Whippoorwills. We're hoping for three more relays and several other individuals to join the championship team. Come check them out at a meet if you get a chance. Swim and dive.
Next up, we have our girls basketball team. Come on down, ladies. As they're making their way to the floor, this season's varsity captains are seniors Sarah Piper and Katrina Knox. This Rams team is led by upperclassmen Sarah Piper, Katrina Knox, and Madison Zabaski as they set the tone for what they hope will be their first playoff appearance in many seasons. They're quite excited about that, the positive changes the program has seen, and they continue to grow and build a winning culture. Ladies and gentlemen, the girls basketball team.
Next up, we have the boys basketball team. Led by captains Owen Llewellyn, Andrew Lamandola, and Josh Gimble. Boys basketball team has three returning lettermen, competed in Section 1 6A Conference's 22-23 season. Led by our captains and a very young team, we were able to defeat the defending Whippoorwill champion Fox Chapel team at home in early December and compete with one of the most challenging schedules in the Whippoorwill. Contributing significant minutes for the varsity squad are Emery Moy, Vasily Valoris, Carson Bear, Eli Catalano, Doolin Stober, Eli Wentz, Grant Spachipoli, and Zach Kenny. A very bright future ahead for our Pine Richland Rams.
Pine Richland Wrestling. Come on down.
dressing room.
Yeah. The Rams wrestling team is currently 5-1 in contention for the section championship. They were in the playoffs the other day. Correct, Captain Joe Schneck? The team's captains. Senior Joey Schneck, Jake Lucas. Where are you at, Jake Lucas? And Anthony Ferraro. Anthony Ferraro got his 100th win not too long ago, correct? Let's see here. And Jake and Joey are also looking for their 100th win this season shortly, correct, gentlemen? Excellent. The team was runner-up at county champions this year by beating North Allegheny. Boo. And 36 other schools. The team is qualified for the Whipple Team Tournament as well, and we have the seniors this year, 51-15 overall team record over the last 4 years, 51-15. Great job, senior guys. Congratulations, your Pine Richland wrestling team.
Next up on the floor is the ice hockey team. Come on up, gentlemen. Varsity hockey, they are on a roll, earning points in 8 of their last 11 games, including an undefeated month of December, earning wins against Erie Cathedral Prep, Mount Lebanon, and defending state champions, Peters Township. The varsity ice hockey team continued their momentum in the month of January by beating rival North Allegheny in a thrilling overtime win and also earning a win against Seneca Valley. They are excited to work towards solidifying a playoff spot and making a run at a state championship. The varsity hockey team is led by senior players, including assistant captains Jack Breisinger, Jordan Spear, and the captain Josh Fulmer. Set an alarm or set a reminder on your phones for February the 16th at 8:30 p.m. when they have their senior night versus Bethel Park at Barrel Ice Complex. That is your boys ice hockey team.
Next up, come on down, the gymnastics squad. The gymnastics team will be looking to add to the successes of Pine Richland Sports and win a Whipple championship. Led by senior captains, Kylie Hughes, Avery Klein, Ava Romano, and Megan Sharp. They don't call it gymnastics, kids. Congratulations again to the gymnastics squad.
Congratulations, ladies. Up next is the competitive cheer team. Come on out, competitive cheer. These are the people that cheer for you. You gotta remember that. The varsity competitive cheer team has had a very successful competition season so far, placing third higher in all the competitions. They received a bid to the UCA Nationals in Orlando, Florida. Congratulations. At a regional competition as well in October. And they also received to the PIAA state competition with a top three finish and hit the routines in the Whipple Competitive Spirit Championship as well. The girls finish out their season competing at states and at nationals, where they've placed 8th last week. Congratulations, ladies. And we hope to make you guys make the finals. Congratulations, competitive cheer.
Stay put, ladies, hold on 1 second because sideline cheer is here as well. Go ahead back up. For the sideline cheer team, that's the rest of them, here they come. The varsity sideline cheer team wrapped up their football season in December. The team shifted its focus to basketball, where they are continuing to cheer presently. The 2023 seniors continue to lead the team with spirit and pride. We're proud of them too. Please give them a round of applause, the sideline cheer team.
Next up, let's make some noise for our bocce team. Yeah. This is the second year for our unified bocce team. Last year, we made it to the state championship where we came in fifth place. This year, we have four games. Please come out and support the squad as we hit the playoffs in March. Congratulations again to the bocce team.
And now we'd like to call out two individuals for their accomplishments this year. The first, you may have heard of this young man, Ryan Palmieri. Ryan is one of the first here, this is a few other people as well, is the Pennsylvania 5A Player of the Year in football. Congratulations, guys. And also, we'd like to call out Owen Llewellyn, one of the captains of the basketball team, where he is the Burger and Green Scholar Athlete for the Whippoorwill in Pine Richland. Congratulations, bud. Good luck tonight, Seneca Valley, right? Excellent. Right now, we would like to call out Mrs. Green.
University majoring in marketing. Next is Andrew Sermonero. Andrew is the son of Cynthia and Tony Sermonero. He plays football and is a member of FBLA. He plans to attend a four-year university, and Andrew is being escorted by Ella Schilling. Ella is the daughter of Andrea and David Schilling. She is a member of Young Life and Best Buddies. Ella plans to attend a four-year university. Next up is Jack Duckworth. Jack is the son of Tracy Howe and Michael Duckworth. He participates in mock trial, tennis, and ski club. He plans to attend a four-year university. Jack is being escorted by Elle Hengelsberg. Elle is the daughter of Leslie Velsick and David Hengelsberg. She participates in environmental club, forensics, and book club. Elle plans to attend a four-year university. Next is Jack Exline. Jack is the son of Jennifer and David Exline. He is the president of French Club, International Thespian Society, and the choir department. He plans to attend a four-year university majoring in theater and psychology. Jack is being escorted by Sydney Jones. Sydney is the daughter of Wendy and Jan Jones. She is involved in marching band, musical, and choir. Sydney plans to attend Slippery Rock University majoring in English secondary education. Next up is Toby Kate. Toby is the son of Rachel Stone and Doug Kate. He is the president of both the Pickleball Club and Astronomy Club, is treasurer of Best Buddies, and captain of the varsity golf team. He plans to attend a four-year university to study business. Toby is being escorted by Kendall Chilcote. Kendall is the daughter of Kimmy and Mike Chilcote. She is president of both the senior class and Best Buddies and is on the varsity cheerleading team. Kendall plans to attend a four-year university to study education. Next up, we have Kale Claff. Kale is the son of Alexandra and Tamira Claff. He plays varsity soccer and is a member of OHM, Minithon, and the Lip Dub Committee. He plans to attend a four-year university to study environmental science. Kale is being escorted by Manon Prakash. Manon is the daughter of Fabienne and Michael Prakash. She plays varsity soccer and is a member of OHM. Manon plans to attend a four-year university. Next up, we have Jack Mill. Jack is the son of Ann and Mark Mill. He participates in varsity ice hockey, varsity track, FBLA, and minithon. He plans to attend a four-year university to study business finance. Jack is being escorted by Ava Boyd. Ava is the daughter of Megan and Jim Boyd. She plays on the girls' soccer team. Ava plans to attend Michigan State University to play D1 soccer. Next is Ryan Palmieri. Ryan is the son of Lisa and Don Palmieri. He plays football and intramural basketball. He'll be attending Sacred Heart University to study finance and play football. Ryan is being escorted by Ava Romano. Ava is the daughter of Allison and Jeff Romano. She's part of the gymnastics team, track, and peer buddies. Ava plans to attend a four-year university to study psychology. Next is John Roddinghouse. John is the son of Margie and Dave Roddinghouse. He's a member of the football team and intramural basketball. He plans to attend Duquesne University for health sciences. John is being escorted by Gianna Koss. Gianna is the daughter of Teresa and Jason Koss. She's on the girls' soccer team. Gianna plans to attend the University of Kentucky to major in business and play soccer. Last but not least is Colin Zvanix. Colin is the son of Karen and Eric Zvanix. Colin is the captain of varsity soccer, the president of Spanish club, and vice president of anatomy club. He plans to attend a four-year university to major in molecular biology. Colin is being escorted by Ella Giesick. Ella is the daughter of Amy and Eric Giesick. She is an officer for NHS, Forensics Model UN, and is the secretary of Spanish club. Ella plans to attend a four-year university to major in sociology. Let's have a round of applause for our 2023 Winter Court. All right, the second runner-up is a tie, I know, between Jack Duckworth and Ryan Palmieri. Our first runner-up is Jack Exline. Yeah! All right, and this year's 2023 Winter King is Tommy Baker. Yeah! For some academic recognitions.
Hello, Pine Richland. All right, so we're gonna keep the ball rolling. We've got some academic recognitions to make. Basically, our teachers had the opportunity to nominate students for any kind of service or anything that they've gone above and beyond. So please help me cheer on the following students. And students, when you come up, you'll just stand right along that line. Okay. Yash Shah. Yash earned fourth place at the Mercer Speech and Debate Tournament in extemporaneous speaking. Eunice Sun. Eunice earned third place at the Mercer Speech and Debate Tournament in extemporaneous speaking. Logan Blackwell. Logan is dedicated to helping those less fortunate. He has been an integral leader in planning many mini-thon events and is responsible for raising thousands of dollars for kids with cancer. Shreyashi Mundal. Shreyashi is actually being nominated for two different things at this moment. Shreyashi earned a Coca-Cola scholarship. She's a semi-finalist and selected among 1,557 students from over 91,000 applicants across the country for their academic excellence, leadership, and service. She's also being recognized as 18 under 18 for junior achievement, recognized as one of the region's most incredible young people. Next up, we have Chloe Chang. Chloe is the co-president of the Asian Culture Club. Students interested in Asian culture get together and celebrate the various Asian cultures. Club events encourage unity and a growing appreciation for various heritages. Next up, Abby Ewing. Abby earned a Silver Key Award from the Scholastics Writing Competition. We also have Katrina Knox. Katrina earned a Gold Key Award from the Scholastics Writing Competition. Next up, we have Rachel Muth. Rachel has been a participating member of SASH for years. As a strong leader, she advocates for students' needs as well as educates her peers on the importance of social justice. Congratulations, Rachel. Next up, we've got Noah Oriana, Shreyashi Mandal, and Brandon Weiss. This team here co-planned and organized a 12-hour coding marathon for 165 students for Hack the RAM last weekend. And if you have never seen that, it is the most incredible experience to see how many students are working on the computer programming all at the same time. It's really incredible. Good job, guys. Next up, we've got Grace Hazlett. Grace auditioned for and was accepted as a violist into the Pennsylvania Music Educators Association Region Orchestra. Next up, Colin Jvanix. Colin demonstrates excellent leadership and serves as a positive role model for all members of Spanish Club. He should also be commended for his efforts in AP Spanish. Muy bien. Next is Alexa Cardinali. Alexa led and coordinated a winter clothing and personal care donation drive to benefit the Light of Life organization. The drive resulted in around 120 care packages and countless coats, gloves, and hats being donated. Next up, we have Katie Yanni. Katie has served hundreds of service hours, earning one President's Award, working on her second by the end of the week, by today, and she has stayed 100% committed to peer-to-peer's goals throughout her entire 4 years here at Pine Richland. Congratulations. Next up, we have Lauren Schwab. I don't know where Lauren is. There she is, she's coming. Lauren has achieved the highest and most prestigious award in Girl Scouting, the Girl Scout Gold Award. That's hard work. Next up, we've got Emma Jaworski. Emma is secretary of Key Club and goes above and beyond from assisting with meetings to planning and starting up the club's social media account. Emma is an active participant at our events and is one of the reasons everything runs smoothly. Nice job. Last up, we've got Liv Rasha. Liv is organized, professional, inclusive, and a decisive leader on the prom committee. And she's really helpful at helping people decide their college roommates. Give them a big hand. Good job on all of your hard work, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. The time we've all been waiting for.
2.5 months of practice, the dance team, for their traditional winter dance, with a handful of gentlemen in the senior class, under the direction of Miss Kathy Deal, here are your Pine Richland dance team. Jack Mill, Rudolph, Cern, Avery Brown, Max Hecker, Joe Perry, Liam Daniello, Sal, Brad Gelly. Thank you.
your Pine Richland Dance Team. Gentlemen, you want to get another shot of that, you can come tonight to Seneca Valley Senior Night for our basketball team to watch that once again tonight, 7:30. Now to show you something a little bit different, one of the classes here at Pine Richland talks about some robots and robots, as Mr. Clark calls it, or Mr. McCurdy calls it, robots. It's Mr. Clark's class and the 4-pound robots for battle bots.
Okay, while bots are setting up, we're actually ahead of schedule, which almost never happens for us. While they're setting up, I'd like to have the comp chair team, if you can come join me up here real quick. Comp chair, if you can come front and center. Competitive chair. Comp chair. Comp chair, comp chair. Okay, wanted to make sure these ladies got a special shout out from us while the battle bots are setting up. Last weekend, our competitive cheer team qualified for the state championship. They were one of 40 teams that competed in Hershey, and this group took home 8th place. Let's give them a huge round of applause. Girls, keep working hard. We are privileged to have you continuing to cheer for all of our sports teams, and we wanted to congratulate you. Congratulations. Yep.
All right, so what we have right here is a 4-pound robot controlled by Brandon Weiss, and it has a handful of different motors on it where it flips things over, smashes some things apart. Matt Urocco as well. They built this robot last year, Mr. Clark. A couple big shots there. Sometimes it's in this cage and it's high strength pencil plexiglass, so nothing comes through. Sometimes thing gets stuck, things like that, so they can call a timeout and work some things around. And they check and make sure everything's clear. And believe it or not, this is under the direction of Mr. Clark. And sometimes, you know, things get stuck in there, things break. They compete in April. In a handful of different places. There's a 20-pound robot as well. You take it in advanced robotics and EDD and applied engineering tech. But the guys wanted to show you how some things work. They had an old computer in there. finish him. Nice job, guys. Nice job. Right now we have, after the cage gets cleared out, we're going to have a balloon battle between two captains. We have 18 participants. Mr. Basham's going to take over. All right, first up is the balloon race. Two captains from each team, 9 teams, 18 participants. One balloon will be tied to the ankle of each participant, and they will try to pop the other balloons, try to get them out. Last person standing will be the winner.
Okay, so what we're pulling up for you now is something special that the school is going to be doing this spring.
Lip dub coming soon.
To get the whole school involved.
Everyone will be in it. Don't be too cool. No one's too cool for the lip dub. Everyone, lip dub on three. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah. So we're really excited to bring this to you guys this year. We put a lot of work into it, and we hope you guys are excited too. So now I'm gonna give it to your winter court king, Tommy Baker.
Hello, everyone. I would like to give a huge thank you to our administration team under Dr. Hernandez this year. Everything's been really great. Having you as our principal and everything's running a lot smoother and we can do fun things like these. We'd like to thank our custodial staff for everything that they do and for the lip dub and just a future thank you for everyone. So from all of our officers, roll Rams! And we love Mrs. Green. She's in charge of all this.
All right, right now we're looking for two captains from each team. Mr. Basham, you got everyone ready to go? Got our teams? All right. Balloon battle, each two. Two captains from each one. Balloon battle. Balloon battle. You guys in this? No? Balloon battle, two of each. You're all tied in. Are we staying within the volleyball lines? Staying within the volleyball court? All right, we're going basketball court first, so slide back a little bit. Basketball court first. Mr. Basham's gonna use one of the main things in gym, a timer, stopwatch. Mr. Basham, are you ready? Mr. Basham has the time. Once your balloon gets popped, you gotta get out. 3, 2, 1, go. Have some wrestlers over here. Dan Muldoon, sneaking around. Delaney Allen for the swim team. Come on, Delaney. Mac Miller, knocking some people out. Come on, Emma, make something happen. You can't stop Emma Rowe. Half court. We are half court now, Dan Muldoon, half court. Everyone at half court. Half court. Get over there, Delaney. Half court. Half court. Here we go. Come on, Miller. Let's go. Come on, Emma Rowe. Dan Muldoon, sneak attack. One minute. Emma may have a heart attack. Emma's out. Emma Rowe, everyone. Bob Rowe's granddaughter, good guy. All right, three-point line, inside the three-point line. Inside the three-point line, here we go. Two hockey players left, basketball, two basketball. Shot put, oh, Muldoon. Delaney Allen, swimmer. Shot put thrower extraordinaire.
Oh,
All right, here we go. In the paint, in the paint, in the paint. Make it happen. Can't step out in the back. Stay in, stay in. Twenty seconds. Delaney's out. 10 seconds, everyone, count it down. 10 seconds. 10, 9. Tie game. Congrats, gentlemen, congrats. Scooter relay, people, who's up? The person that's starting, get on each green cone. Your partner will be directly across from you. These plungers have been used for the past 15 years, but they have been cleaned. Mr. Basham cleaned them yesterday. They're clean. One scooter, two plungers per team. Obstacles set up across the gym. Participants will go around using the plungers across the floor. We have to, if you can, cross your legs and sit Indian style. If you can. I'm not that flexible. That's what Mr. Basham said. He makes the rules up. Don't look at me. There's a king right here. How you doing, king?
I'm amazing.
Mr. Basham, are you ready? Partners are across. 3, 2, 1, go. Get back on. No feet, do not use your feet. Hockey team coming through. Niter. Come on, Joe. Second place, I guess you won. Ask Mr. Basham. There we go. No, right there. Bocce team there. All right, top four teams going full court. We got basketball, hockey, bocce team, and was it swimming? I couldn't tell who was down here. Miss Mo, who was down here? Who was fourth down here? All right, we're going full court. We start down here. Full court, overall winner. All right, that just down, then back. So get your other team down there. Get your other team member down there. You got basketball, hockey, swimming and diving. No, you have to sit on your butt. Hey, look who showed up. We have a new staff member. His name's Little Troy. Hey, Little Troy, how are you, guy? Hey, Little Troy. Get on that camera, it's Little Troy. Hey, Little Troy, you watching everything? You're like Flat Stanley. What, you didn't say anything. Here we go, 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, Mr. Bogat's figured it out. Swimming team has figured it out. He got a big game tonight against Seneca Valley. Snyder's killing it right here. One of the leaders right here. Cruises in. Hockey, first place. What do you think of that, Flat Troy? Troy, you're not saying anything. Maybe you'll have a chance in dodgeball, Flat Troy. Here we go, Joe, come on. Gotta get you 8 more wins to get that 100th win. Wrestling 2. Third place, here we go. Congratulations, everyone. Hungry, hungry hippos. Hungry, hungry hippos. Joe, watch. Don't run into Flat Troy. Don't run into Little Troy, okay? All right, we got 2 groups for Hungry, Hungry Hippos. We want girls basketball first, gymnastics, boys hoops, and ice hockey are first. They are first. The first 4 teams we rattled off right there. And then everyone else come off to the side. You come over here and stand beside Little Flat Troy if you want. He has no friends. Little Flat Troy has no friends. All right, so we got 1 scooter, 1 laundry basket per team. 1 partner is on their stomach on the scooter, and the other partner holds their legs. They must maneuver to collect as many balls on the gym floor and into the laundry basket as possible. There is a time limit. All right, how many teams are we going first? 4 teams are first. First 4 teams. Not everyone's gone at once. Not everyone's gone at once. The second teams, if you guys, you should practice a little bit. Should practice a little bit. Oh my God, look at this. Miss Shear would have a nightmare with all these balls everywhere. Hungry, hungry hippos. As many as you can. How much time do we have, Mr. Basham? 30 seconds. 3, 2, 1, go. Don't use your arms. Don't use your arms, wrestling. Try to get as many as you can. Try to get as many as you can. We're going to have 2 rounds. We're going to have to get some math teachers down here to count. I don't know if Mr. Basham can count that high. Mr. Duggar, look, it's the guy you look, Flat Troy's here. All right. Well, Mr. Basham wants to go a minute. Balls everywhere. Try to keep them in there. 15 seconds. Five seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, would each team, oh no, Flat Stanley, Flat Troy. Let's get Flat Troy back up here. There he is. I'll get you stood up, little guy. Count them up, keep them even. There he is. It's little Troy. Count them up evenly, please, don't. All right, where are we at? How many of you guys have basketball? 32, girls? 31? 28? All right, 31 and 32, right? 32, basketball. Nice job. Let's get them back in the center. Let's get them all back in the center. Other 4 teams are up. Corner here, corner here, corner over there, corner over there. Teacher team. Mr. Camberg. Mr. Camberg declines. Mr. Schlimm. Teacher team here. All right, here we go. We got teacher team. As many as you can. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Mr. Slim, don't hurt yourself. Cheerleaders tired of getting on there. Here we go. Hockey team. Hungry hippos. Seconds remain. Oh, they lost a handful there. One team lost a bunch. How much time, Mr. Basham? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Count them up. I would think, just by looking, Mr. Slim showing off a true Eagles fan right there. Count them up. If you can, put them back in the basket. How many we got? How many? 44. Mr. Camberg's a math teacher. He can count. Dodgeball is up. Ball is up. Oh, we have another special guest. Everyone's favorite. Mr. Jim, how are you? All right. I don't know who you need to throw balls at, Jim. Maybe all these kids that create a mess that you're gonna clean up. How much time we got? What time is it? I didn't see the time. I don't have my watch. 2:23, perfect. We are right on time. All right, staff against the winter court. Staff versus the winter court right now. Student section leaders, dance team. As many would say, if you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball. How many we got on the staff team? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 balls on the court. We about 13 on 13, though? We good? Grab the balls. Dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball. Mr. Camber, cheat up a little bit. You're a little older. Once you're hit, you're out. Keep this fair. I heard people complaining last time about basketball. Keep this fair. 3, 2, 1, go.
Move up, move up.
Hey, can we call no boundaries? Is that still a thing?
Serve, sit down, serve.
If you catch it, remember, you catch it, you're out.
Whoa!
Toby.
In the face.
That was nice. Oh, here we go. Why? Guys, you have to throw the ball at people, not up against the back wall. Flat Troy is not over there. Ah, Jim got, how can you hit him?
Boo.
Was that, who was that? Ryan Palmieri hit him? Oh, Rovati. Oh, good throw, Sal, good throw. Here we go, here we go. Creeping. Rivati, you out. That's what you get for taking Jim out, Rivati. Watch Mr. McNally back there. Ooh, Avery Brown bringing the heat, getting ready for baseball. Come on, Kel Clapp. Out. All teachers, you can cross up to here. All teachers up to here, go across the center line. Up to here, right here. All teachers. Oh, you just hit the PA 5A champ. Avery Brown, you're out, you cross the line. Avery Brown's out, cross the line. Max Hecker took you out anyway. Half court for you. Nice, oh, John. Duquesne. Here we go, anyone catch one? Let's go, let's go. 4-on-3. You're good. You're good. Ball's gone. Goldsmith, you're out. It's about ready to go. No boundaries here, real quick. Ouch. Oh, you're out. Watch your back. Good. Oh, nice. Here we go, Sal. Here we go. Jailbreak! Jailbreak! All right, here we go. Back in, back in, back in. Hurry up. All right, let's go. Stay off the backcourt. We got to move up. We got to move up. We got to move up. Off that back line. Don't be cheating and hiding back there. Serm out. Avery, wrong kid. Dr. Hernandez, get in there. Let's go. Camberg's out. Uh-oh, creeping. Look here. Nice job, Court. Nice job, Court. Bringing the pain now. Be in the back. Ooh.
Avery Brown. Oh, Brad Kelly. That bounce. You're good, Max. Sorry, Tommy. Good move, John. Good move. Ouch. Guys, watch, Mrs. Ruffner's back here. WVU grad. Mr. We protect you. Mr. Carey, guying people up. Here we go. Move it up, move it up. Oh yeah, totally. Seconds against Mr. Carrick. He's out. Congrats.
All righty. Great job, students. So before we conclude today, there are several individuals that we want to make sure that we thank. To our fun brigade, our winter sports assembly sponsors, Mrs. Green. Let's give her a round of applause, Mrs. Bruff. Really hope that you enjoyed the battle bot. Give Mr. Clark a round of applause. And have a great day, PRHS. Thank you.